Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School. It is the South Division I playoffs as the Hillers, in their second game of the postseason, set to take on the Walpole Rebels, and Bree Mirabli is set to deliver the first pitch of the game, and it is a strike to the Walpole catcher today. And the catcher is Lisa Regan. She is a senior. There's strike two. Mirabli is set to deal. And that one a ball, one and two. Hopkinton Hillers getting a victory yesterday to advance this game here today, as Lisa Regan takes strike three, one away. And that will bring up the pitcher. And the pitcher today is Melissa Cochran. As she is set to step in. Get you updated on the bracket. The Hillers getting the 1-0 victory in the first round over Plymouth South yesterday. And today they are in the quarterfinals against Walpole, as that is hit foul out of the reach of the catcher, Kate Wellzell. Due up next is Catherine Wilmot, the first baseman after Cochran. We'll get the full batting order in just a moment, as there's a swinging strike. Walpole has had quite a road to get to this point, as that one's fouled away. They had a play in the preliminaries and they got an 8-7 victory over 14th seeded North Attleboro. And that was the second out there, as it was fouled right into the catcher's glove. And Walpole's the 19th seed, and then they defeated third-seeded Marshfield 8-5 to get to this round, as Catherine Wilmot takes a strike, the first baseman. Wind up and the pitch. There's another one. A 1-1 count. There's strike two. Early start here today. They were due for a 4 p.m. start and ended up starting at the usual 3:45 time, as this is hit in the air to right field, and that will drop down for a base hit. And aboard with the single is the first baseman, Catherine Wilmot. A beautiful sunny day here in Hillertown. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call for quarterfinals South Division I action. Is now stepping in is the third baseman, Catherine King. That pitch just outside. Mirabli delivers strike one. Now you wonder how Mirabli will be going back-to-back days on the mound. Obviously this happened last year with Juliet Hume. And it was certainly a tough feat for Hume. Throw down a first, runner back safely. Hillers ended up losing that game last year to Notre Dame Academy. And it is certainly not easy to go 2 days in a row. There's another strike. One and two count on Catherine King. Mirabli deals, hit in the air, a high fly ball towards the edge of the infield dirt. It is handled, no problem, for the out by shortstop Molly Bennett. To the bottom of the first we go, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up next. The Hopkinton Hillers coming up on the bottom of the first inning is set to step in as center fielder Lily Morningstar. Wind up and the pitch, that is fouled away. Same lineup as yesterday for the Hillers. We'll run it down for you in just a moment. Pitcher for Walpole is Melissa Cochran, as this is hit in the air to left field, and it's past the reach of the left fielder. Morningstar around first, around second, and she will go all the way safely to third. It is a triple to start things off for Lily Morningstar. She absolutely tattooed that ball to left field. That was past the reach of Tess Lawler, the left fielder. And a good start for the Hillers as Katie Holly will step in. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air to right field towards the fence, and that is off the fence. One run in to score as Holly now rounding second to third, and it's back-to-back triples. The Hopkinton Hillers getting the bats going early. Molly Bennett now steps in. Line up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air, foul territory and out of play. And hold on, did the catcher actually catch that? Nope, just dropped it. Looked like that was heading towards the Hillers dugout area. So an 0-1 count, one run already in, back-to-back triples for the Hillers. As there's a strike, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air. That is going to drop into the glove of the center fielder. Runner at third will hold up as Mackenzie Ray there with the quick throw in. One out in the inning. Kate Wilzell at the plate. Line up and the pitch. That is just low. A 1-0 count to Wilzell. Well, the Hillers getting a 1-0 victory over Plymouth South yesterday, and now the bats getting going early here against Walpole. Is that one down low, 2-0. Wind up and the pitch, and this is chopped over to the shortstop. That's the second out of the inning. So let's run down the Hillers' batting order. Lily Morningstar led things off with a triple. Katie Holly followed up with an RBI triple. Molly Bennett then flew out to center field. She was the third hitter in the lineup, and Kate Wilzell, the fourth hitter, lined out as Heather Hawley hits this one in the air to right field, and it's handled. That will be the third and final out of the first inning, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate a run, and as we head to the top of the second, the Hillers leading 1-0. Top of the second inning, Walpole back up to the plate, trailing 1-0. After back-to-back triples by Morningstar and Katie Holly started things off for the Hillers, Mackenzie Ray at the plate. And she will take a strike. Mackenzie Ray, the center fielder. Line up and the pitch. There's strike two. Let's take you through the Hillers field. Lily Morningstar in center, Katie Holly over in right field, Lindsay Whittles in left. Pitcher Bree Mirabli. Kate Wilzell behind the plate as there is strike three, one away. Over at first base, Isabel Holden. Second base, Emily Whalen. Shortstop, Molly Bennett. Third base, Emma Murphy. And Emma Murphy, the odd man out of the batting order. Line up and the pitch, there's a strike. Michaela Federico, the shortstop at the plate. And the pitch to Federico, that is fouled away. Jacqueline Mulcahy, the designated player on deck. That one's down low. Walpole is led by head coach Rachel Sprague, assisted by Tia Spienza, as there is a ball outside. Tia Sapienza, excuse me, and Dave Lynch. The Hopkinton Hillers, of course, led by head coach Kylie Murray, assisted by Bruce Elliott. There's a strike, and also Kelly McIntyre, an assistant coach for the Hillers. It's out number two. That is the fourth strikeout of the game for Mirabli. As now stepping in is Jacqueline Mokahai, and she'll take a strike. Wind up and the pitch. Here's strike two. The Hillers know they're going to need some runs in this game, more than likely, with Mirabli going her second day in a row on the mound, and it's certainly a great start to get that run in the first inning. As there's strike three. Mirabli strikes out the side, and who knows, she might not need any help at this rate. It is 1-0 Hillers as we head to the bottom of the second. Marie Mirabli at the plate, and she will take ball one. As set to deliver is Cochran, and this is on the ground up the middle, gloved at short, throw to first in time. Mirabli goes 6-3, one away. That'll bring up Lindsay Whittles. Let's take a look at the field for Walpole. Melissa Cochran on the mound, Lisa Regan behind the plate, Catherine Wilmot over at first base, Jada Dingle Brown, the second baseman, Michaela Federico at shortstop, Catherine King, the third baseman, as this is a liner. That'll drop into left center, and rounding first is Whittle. She'll stay put with a single. Isabel Holden now to the plate. From left to right on the Walpole defensive field, Tess Lawler, Mackenzie Ray, and Abigail Ray. For the Walpole Rebels, who have stunned the high school softball world, getting by two higher seed teams to get to this point. As that is in there for a strike. Great win over North Attleboro, 8-7 to start off the tournament in the preliminaries, as that one's fouled away. And then they take down third seeded 17-1 Marshfield. Tremendous upset. The winner of this game will advance to play King Philip at Taunton High School, as that's filed away. And they will actually, according to this schedule, be playing tomorrow at 5 p.m. over at Taunton High School. So that could mean three games in a row for the Hillers. That pitch up high. And then the South Division I championship would be this weekend. That pitch up high. So it's going to be crucial for the Hillers really to get some offense on the board, take the stress off of Mirabli, and perhaps try to pull her early if you can, as there's a strike for out number two. It's the first strikeout of the game for Cochran, and that'll bring up Emily Whalen. Well, it was really the rain delay this past Sunday that put the Hillers in this situation, but they don't care. They're going to take it one game at a time. That one up high. And it's not really a question of the hitters or the fielders getting tired. It's a question of your pitcher. As this is hit in the air, it is in foul territory and out of the reach of the right fielder. 1-1 will remain the count on Emily Whalen, who has been very good with the bat as of late. Wind up and the pitch. And there is a pitch just high, 2-1. Cochran set to deliver. That's it in the air and caught by the third baseman. That'll be the third out of the bottom of the second inning. As we head to the top of the third, it is Walpole 0, the Hillers 1 here on HCAM. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can call them at 508-366-1820 or find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the third inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hillers. Walpole back up to the plate to face Bree Mirabli, who so far, despite pitching her second day in a row, has been spot on, as there's a strike to Tess Lawler, the left fielder. She struck out the side in the last inning. Five strikeouts for Mirabli in this game. There's strike two. Crabley set to deal. Upstairs, one and two. One-two pitch. Strike three. Crabley on a roll. Six strikeouts in this game, and now Abigail Ray will come up.
Go, Abby Ray.
Ray is the ninth hitter in the Walpole lineup. There's strike one. Crabley set to deliver. There's a strike. Crabley deals. Strike three. Seven strikeouts in this game, and that'll bring up Lisa Regan. Regan struck out her only time up in the first inning. Crabley delivers, fouled away. Walpole has gotten the offense going as of late, but the big question is, can they do it against Crabley? Is that bunt's fouled away? 0-2. For those of you just tuning in, it is South Division I semifinal, quarterfinals action. Hillers and Walpole. It's a 1-0 lead for the Hillers, and another strikeout for Crabley in the second straight inning. She strikes out the side. That is eight strikeouts in this game for Crabley. 1-0 Hillers as we head to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third inning, top of the Hillers batting order. Stepping in, Lily Morningstar, who hit a triple and scored a run in the first inning. That one up high. Cochran set to deliver. Here's a strike. 1-1. She deals another strike. One and two. That one down low, 2-2. Set to deliver. And Morningstar gets a piece of this one. That is high fly ball to left field, but playing deep and making the catch is Tess Lawler for out number one. One away, and that'll bring up Katie Holly. Katie Holly hit the RBI triple her last time up to drive in Morningstar. Take strike one there. Temperatures in the low 80s for this one. Is that one outside? There is a chance of thunderstorms later on this afternoon, but as of right now, the radar clear. Set to deliver. Hit in the air. It is in foul territory and handled by the right fielder. A nice catch as she runs on to the batting cages. Abigail Ray with that one. That is the second out of the inning. Molly Bennett to the plate. Walpole, a very good defensive team. Lineup and the pitch. There's a strike, and also at times can get the bats going, but I think any team would have a tough time with Crabley on the mound getting the bats going. There's another strike. Set to deliver. That's fouled away. Count remains 0-2. Line Setup and the pitch, and that's fouled away. Good battle here between Bennett and Cochran. Set to deliver. There's strike three. Nice pitch there by Cochran. And that is out number three and inning number three. To the top of the fourth we go. It's a 1-0 lead for the Hillers. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. Bedding, container plants, vegetables, culinary herbs, bark, mulch, firewood, and more. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Top half of the fourth inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hillers. The Rebels of Walpole coming back up to the plate to face Bree Mirabli, who has struck out the side in the past two innings. Melissa Cochran will step in, the pitcher. And Mirabli set to deliver. There's a swinging strike. 0-1. Eight strikeouts in the game so far for Mirabli. Fouled away. 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away. Count remains 0-2 on Cochran. The 2, 3, and 4 hitters due up for Walpole. There's strike three. The 7th consecutive strikeout for Mirabli, 9th of the game. Catherine Wilmont to the plate. Mirabli delivers, strike one. Wind up and the pitch, down low. 1-1. Strike two. One and two. This is hit in the air, a high fly ball. Is it in reach? No. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. Good battle here between Wilmont and Mirabli. Catherine King, the third baseman, due up next for Walpole. Mirabli deals, that's fouled away. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike three. Eight straight strikeouts for Mirabli, 10 overall. Catherine King to the plate. Wind up and the pitch, strike one. Mirabli deals on the ground, fielded at short, throw to first, no problem. Nice strong throw by Molly Bennett. And they go down 1-2-3 in the top of the fourth as we head to the bottom of the inning. The Hillers leading 1-0. First pitch of the bottom of the fourth was just outside as Roselle awaits this pitch and hits it in the air. Right side, fair territory, handled by the second baseman, Jada Brown. One away. Heather Holly will now come up to the plate. Cochran delivers down low. Cochran set to deal. First base side foul. Heather Holly's been good with the bat as of late. Takes a strike. Heather Holly actually scored the only run in the victory against Plymouth South. She scored it in the second inning after reaching on an error. On the ground, up the middle, fielded by the pitcher. A little flip to first, no problem. Two away. Mirabli to the plate. Fouled away. Set to deliver. Down low. One and one. Hit in the air. It is in foul territory, handled by the first baseman, Catherine Wilmot, for the little pop out. And that will wrap up the fourth inning. 1-0 Hillers as we head to the fifth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. You can find them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Top of the fifth inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hillers. Mackenzie Ray, the center fielder, stepping in for the Walpole Rebels. Line up and the pitch, the bunt up the middle. Mirabli picks it up, throw to first, off the ground. Whalen has it. What a great job by Whalen, scooping up that low throw. Look out for Emily Whalen, folks. Great on both sides, offensively and defensively. Only a freshman, going to be a key player on this team for the next 3 years. That pitch down low to Michaela Federico. Well, more than likely will be a key player on this team for the next 3 years. There's a strike. One and one. Mirabli deals. This is on the ground, up the middle, past the dive of Whalen. It's a base hit. It's a single, and she stepped off the bag for a second but got right back as Bennett almost threw down, and that'll bring up Jacqueline Molokai. So runner on first, one out. And Molokai, the lefty, set to step in to face Mirabli. Big opportunity here for Walpole. Bunt pulled back, there's a strike, throw down to first, and it'll get into right field. Runner's going to stay put. Quickly gobbled up by Katie Holly. Rabley deals the bunt. There's a strike, throw to first, and Whalen almost laying down the tag. See what they're doing in that situation. They bring Isabel Holden in, and they push Whalen, the second baseman, over to that first base bag. There's strike three, two away. Walpole knows that they're gonna try, more than likely, have to manufacture a run if they wanna tie this game up. Tess Lawler, the left fielder, takes strike one, throw down to first, and runner back safe. Well, Zell certainly not afraid to throw down the line. Mirabli deals upstairs. Lively delivers. Strike two. One and two. There's strike three. Bree Mirabli just racking up the K's in this game. She has 12 overall. As we head to the bottom of the fifth, it's 1-0 Hillers. Bottom of the fifth inning, Lindsay Whittles stepping in. She awaits the pitch from Melissa Cochran. Swinging strike. Right up and the pitch. Hit in the air, a high fly ball towards left field, and it's handled out number one. Tess Lawler was there. And not a whole lot of sun of battle in that left field either, as Isabel Holden will step in. That is up high. Right up and the pitch, just low. 2-0. There's a strike. Come on, Is. Come on now. Here we go. 2-1. Cochran deals. And this is a line into center field. That'll drop in. Holden will hold up at first. A one-out single as Emily Whalen will come to the plate. The bunt foul. Two up after Emily Whalen is Lily Morningstar, the leadoff hitter.
Come on, Mel. Hey, Emily, go do it now. Shoot a gap.
Cochran deals. On the ground, first base side. That'll get through into right field. It'll be a single for Whalen. Holden advances to second. Back-to-back singles for the Hillers. Now Lily Morningstar coming up to the plate. She's 1-for-2 today, had a triple to start off the game, and scored a run as the following hitter, Katie Holly, hit an RBI triple. Big opportunities for security here for the Hillers. Wind up and the pitch, down low. Cochran delivers, and this is hit in the air, and that is going to drop in a shallow left field. All the runners going to advance. The throw to third is in time. They get the leadoff runner. The runners were holding up to see if Lawler was going to be able to make the catch. And a nice play by Lawler as it drops in front, and the throw over to third to get the leadoff runner. So Holden. Out going to third, Whalen up to second, Morningstar to first on the fielder's choice. There's a swinging strike. And that is the very rare 7-5 fielder's choice. Cochran deals upstairs, 1-1. Cochran delivers, and this is hit down the left side, foul. Well, it was certainly risky for the runners to just immediately try to advance on that, but it should have at least been halfway down the base path. As this is hit in the air, left side and caught. That will wrap up the inning despite a pair of hits by the Hillers. No runs score. And as we head to the top half of the sixth inning, the Hillers lead Walpole 1-0. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Fletcher Tilton Attorneys at Law, serving central Massachusetts and beyond. You can find them online at FletcherTilton.com. Top half of the sixth inning, a 1-0 lead for the Hillers as Walpole will come back up to the plate, fighting for their postseason lives. Down to their final six outs. Brabley set to deliver. The bunt down to third baseline, throw to first in time. Very well executed defensively by the Hillers. Again, they pull the first baseman Holden in. Whalen covers the bag and they get the out. One away as Lisa Regan will come up. Line up to, and the pitch, that is down to third base side. That is going to get into left field. Pass the reach of Emma Murphy. She'll stay put at first. A one out single for Regan, and that'll bring up Melissa Cochran. Cochran 0 for 2, has struck out twice. There's a ball throw down to first. Runner is out! What a throw down the line! And a great tag by Whalen. Regan picked off of first base, two away. Well, Zell and Whalen get it done. Hit in the air, high fly ball to right field. Katie Holly battling the sun makes the catch. And that is a huge sigh of relief for Bree Mirabli and the Hillers. You certainly want to try to keep that pitch count down as low as you can, as if the Hillers pull off the victory, they will be playing once again tomorrow. We head to the bottom of the sixth, Hopkinton leading 1-0. Bottom of the sixth inning, the Hillers trying to add some security as they lead Walpole 1-0. A great defensive top of the sixth for the Hillers. Lisa Regan picked off of first base, a beauty of a throw down the line by Kate Wilzell, and a great tag by Emily Whalen for the second out of the inning. This is a bunt picked up by the first baseman and a throw up to the second baseman. Good defensive play there for Walpole as Bennett will go down on the bunt attempt. That'll bring up Kate Wilzell. Another great pitcher's duel here in Hopkinton. That one down low, 1-0. Melissa Cochran pitching a nice game. As this is hit in the air, foul territory, is it playable? Yes! Nice catch by the catcher. Two away. Lisa Regan behind home plate there. Heather Holly now with another opportunity at the plate. As that is hit foul, 0-1. Lined up and the pitch down low. 1-1. Cochran set to deliver. And this is lined past the reach of the second baseman into right field. And that'll be a single for Heather Holly. A two-out single, and that'll bring up Bree Mirabli. And we're gonna have a pinch runner here for the Hillers. As coming in to pinch run will be Katie Sylvester, the freshman. Now the umpire, I just believe, confirming the change. And now there's perhaps some further discussion. It might be as appears to talk about a typo on the lineup. Rabley listed as 16 on the lineup. But that has since been cleared up, and we are ready for more softball. The windup and the pitch. Upstairs, that gets away. Sylvester is going to try to advance to second, and the throw down, there will be none as Sylvester will advance on the wild pitch. So a runner in scoring position with two outs. Upstairs. Cochran set to deal. Low. 3-0. Wind up and the pitch. Ball four. Grabley gets the free pass to first. Lindsay Whittles now coming to the plate. The lefty awaits the pitch. Hit in the air, foul. Top of the batting cage. Oh, and one. Whittles, 1-for-2 today, had a single in the second. There's a strike, 0-2. Cochran delivers. Upstairs, 1-2. The pitch to the lefty. Hit in the air, over to right field, towards the fence, and that'll drop in front of the right fielder. One run in to score, a second run being waved around. Mirabli coming to home plate and will score the third Hillers run. A 2-RBI triple by Lindsay Whittles. And the Hillers add security. Katie Sylvester pinch running for Heather Hawley comes around, and Bree Mirabli comes around. Just what the doctor ordered for the Hillers. And now we'll get an infield discussion on the pitcher's circle as Isabel Holden set to come to the plate for the Hillers. And that relieves the stress a little bit in the seventh inning. Cochran set to deal to Holden. There's strike one. 0-1. Two outs in the inning. Two more runs in for the Hillers. One inside. 1-1. Swinging strike. 1-2. Down low. And this is line pass off the glove of the shortstop. Whittles around to score. An RBI single for Isabel Holden. It's 4-0 Hillers. Now Emily Whalen to the plate. And this is hit in the air, and it is going to be dropped by the second baseman, Brown. And now the throw to second, and that is going to advance Holden up to third, and Whalen back to the back at first. So Whalen reaching on the error by the second baseman. Olden ends up at third base. As the second baseman threw to second base, but it wasn't a tag up situation. So Holden just took off her third. And now Lily Morningstar will come to the plate. Miller is certainly loving the security, that's for sure. There's a strike. Cochran set to deal. Down low. One and one. Line up and the pitch. Down low. Two and one on Morningstar. Line up and the delivery. There's a strike, two and two. Katie Holly due up next if Morningstar is able to reach. And that would mean also the Hillers batted around. Upstairs, three and two, and stealing second base is Emily Whalen. The speedster takes off. Two runners in scoring position now for the Hillers. That's fouled away. Morningstar scored the first run of the game in the top of the first, bottom of the first inning. Lineup and the pitch. And this is in fair territory, up the infield dirt. The flip to first is going to be in time, so they will get Morningstar. You could score that a 3-4 flip for the third out, but the Hopkinton Hillers add well-needed security. They play three runs in the bottom of the sixth. It's 4-0 as we head to the top of the seventh. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. Find them online at westonnurseries.com. Top half of the seventh inning, a 4-0 lead for the Hillers as this is hit in the air and it is in foul territory and dropped by the catcher, Welzel, but she had to really battle the sun on that one. 0-1 to Catherine Wilmot, the first baseman. Sun just glaring around first base side. Fouled away 0-2. So Mirabli with a little bit more of a comfortable situation to work with as the Hillers plate three more runs in the bottom of the sixth to make it a 4-0 lead. And this is crushed into center field, back towards the fence, and it is off the glove of Morningstar and will go off her glove past the fence, and that is going to be a home run. That is certainly a rough one for Morningstar, and she had a hard collision with the wall out there. So now those three runs you scored in the bottom of the inning really mean something. That'll bring up Catherine King. Morningstar giving the thumbs up, signaling she's okay. Hard collision with the wall out there. And that is the worst when the ball goes right off your glove past that wall. As this is hit in the air, foul, 0-1. Rabley deals, that's fouled away 0-2. Fouled away. Rabley being forced to throw in this inning. Dabbley deals upstairs. One and two. Catherine Wilmot, the first baseman for Walpole, started off the seventh with a solo shot. And it's up the middle, glove by Whalen. Throw to first, a little bit high, and it pulls the first baseman off the bag. A single for Catherine King. Oh, you have to make that play. Rabley set to deal. That's fouled away, 0-1. Rabley deals. This is a liner up the middle. Glove by Whalen. Throw to first. They'll get one, but the runner, Catherine King, did get by her. And now they're arguing that Whalen tagged her, which it looked like she may have from here. She definitely went for the tag in her area. She may have missed the runner, though. I'm not sure. But once there's a ruling, it's really hard to change it since there's no replay system. So runner on second, one out, Michaela Federico to the plate. There's a ball, and Hiller's preparing for the steal here. There's a strike. Mirabli deals. Upstairs. Wind up and the pitch. And there is a ball. Rabley to the set, fouled away. Rabley set to deliver. Hit in the air, high fly ball, third base side, and just past the reach of Emma Murphy. Rabley set to deliver. And this is hit in the air to center field. That'll drop down. A run being waved around, and the runner will score. It is an RBI double by Federico. So 4-2, excuse me, is the score. Jacqueline Mulcahy will come to the plate now. 4-2. But Federico over at second, still one out in the inning. You had the home run by Catherine Wilmot to start off the inning. And a single by Catherine King. Mackenzie Ray grounded out. And King advanced to second. And then you have Federico with the RBI double to make it 4-2. Hillers. Rabley set the deal to Mulcahy. There's a strike. Well, I think you could tell Mirabli maybe getting a little tired out there. He's had to throw a lot of pitches, especially in this inning. And let's not forget, this is her second day in a row pitching. That one fouled away 0-2. Hiller's just two outs away, however, from advancing. They have the two-run advantage. Grabley deals. Check swing. Did she hold? Yes. One and two. And that looked like a good call from the umpire from here as well. Grabley delivers. Upstairs, two and two. Well, she's having a tough time getting her pitches to drop into the strike zone. That one fouled away. And they're staying up in the zone right now compared to the enormous drop that they have usually. And that's a sign that the pitcher's getting a little bit tired out there. That one's fouled away. Count remains two and two. Grabley deals. Strike three! Two away. Thirteenth strikeout of the game for Grabley. Tess Lawler to the plate. Runner on second, two in for Walpole. Strike one. It is a 4-2 game. Grabley delivers, strike two. There's the fastball. For the win, upstairs. Line up and the pitch. Strike three, and the Hopkinton Hillers have done it. Despite a threat in the seventh inning from Walpole, they end up scoring two runs, but not enough as the Hillers get the 4-2 victory over the Walpole Rebels. Some great pitching by Bree Grabley once again to help the Hillers walk away with the victory and advance. They will be playing at Totten High School tomorrow against King Philip as they get the 4-2 victory over the Walpole Rebels. Walpole scored two runs on five hits, committed one error, while the Hopkinton Hillers, they ended up scoring four runs on eight hits and committed one error, but a great game and a great win for the Hillers. Quick recap, first inning is when the first run scored for Hopkinton. Katie Hawley followed up a Lily Morningstar triple with a triple of her own, a drive-in Morningstar to make it 1-0. And then we would see no more runs until the bottom of the sixth inning, in which the Hillers added some security. With two outs, Heather Hawley came up, hit a single. Bree Grabley then walked, and then Lindsay Whittles got the job done with a two RBI triple, and that was followed up with an Isabel Holden RBI single for the Hillers' fourth run of the game. And then in the seventh inning, for Walpole, Catherine Wilmot led off the inning with a home run that went off of the glove of Morningstar, past the center field fence, and then you had Catherine King hit a single. That was followed up with a Mackenzie Ray ground out, but then a RBI double by Michaela Federico made it 4-2 and put the tying run at the plate. But then Grabley got two straight strikeouts to get out of the inning, and the Hopkinton Hillers get the 4-2 victory over Walpole in the quarterfinals of the South Division I playoffs. They will advance to the semifinals and be taking on King Philip in the next round at Totten High School. Congratulations to the Hopkinton Hillers. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us for this broadcast of Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. Enjoy the rest of your day, everybody.